We will continue a discussion of the model reference system design using the Lapunov stability techniques. This time, we will consider design of a state variable control system using the Lapunov approach. You understand that this system is supposed to be stable. Moreover, it should be globally asymptotically stable, and this will result in perfect asymptotic adaptation. In other words, regardless of the initial difference between the adjustable system and the reference model, the eventual discrepancy between the reference model and the adjustable system will be close to zero. Global asymptotic stability or perfect asymptotic adaptation. All right, this is the reference model. It represents the desired closed-loop dynamics of the entire system. This is the state equation. Matrix AM and matrix BM represent properties of the reference model. R is the reference signal. X is the state vector. And you understand, since input is R reference, then the equation represents the closed-loop dynamics. Only in the closed-loop system, input signal is reference. For the control plant, you have the traditional state equation of the plant. Y is the state vector, AP is the fundamental matrix, BP is matrix B, and U is the control effort applied to the control plant. It is quite different from the reference, because control effort is defined according to this matrix equation. W is the filter in the reference channel. It should be multiplied by the reference minus state variable feedback. State variable feedback is represented by the matrix F of the state variable controller and the state vector of the control plant. If I would take this expression for U and insert it into the equation for the control plant, I will get the state equation for the closed-loop system. Now, the input for the closed-loop system is the reference. Why the state vector of the plant is state vector of the closed-loop system? I actually can rewrite this equation calling AP minus BPF, fundamental matrix of the closed-loop system, A closed-loop system. BP times W, I can call matrix B of the closed-loop system. The error is state generalized error. It is found as the state vector of the reference model minus the state vector of the adjustable system. And the adaptation in the system, the adaptation mechanism, is represented by these two matrix equations. The one that defines matrix A of the adjustable system, and this one that defines matrix B of the adjustable system, or matrix A of the closed-loop system and matrix B of the closed-loop system. The next what is done, we define the Lapunov equation. The Lapunov equation is supposed to be an equation of all state variables of the model reference system. Obviously, state variables of the model reference system include more than just error. They include every single parameter, every single factor that changes with time. Now, this expression is quite formidable. And this expression, fortunately, you and I do not have to create. This equation, this definition of the Lapunov function, is provided to us by professional mathematicians who work in this area. Want to remind you that this is trace of a matrix. The matrix is in this parentheses, and trace of a matrix is the sum of diagonal elements. This is trace of another matrix in this equation. What the mathematicians guarantee to you and me is that this Lyapunov function is positive definite function, which means that value v is always greater than zero, except the origin. In the origin, when every state variable is zero, the Lyapunov function is supposed to be equal to zero, positive definite function. Now, in this expression, there are three matrices. They are square matrices, and they are all positive definite matrices. What do we know about the positive definite matrices? We know this. If I would take a transposed vector of the appropriate dimension and multiply it by a positive definite matrix, and then multiply result by the same state vector, I'm getting a positive scalar, regardless of the vector that we use. Definition for positive definite matrices. The next expression is even more formidable. This is the derivative of the Lyapunov function, and for sure, I cannot take a derivative like this. But it's our responsibility to make sure that the derivative of the Lyapunov function is negative definite. How can we handle this situation? There are three terms in this equation, in this expression. The first term is a state vector transposed times the square matrix, post multiplied by the state vector. State vector in our case is a vector of errors in the system. And these two terms depend on the adaptation mechanism. This is derivative of matrix A of the adjustable system. It defined as a function of error and time. Of course, it's a adaptation mechanism. Right here, we can see derivative of matrix B of the adjustable system, defined as a function of error and time. What do we do with the Lyapunov, with the derivative of the Lyapunov function? First of all, you see this positive definite matrix P? What we want to do is to make sure that P is chosen such that this sum will be a negative definite matrix. Well, a negative definite matrix we define as taking a positive definite matrix and placing a minus in front of it. If we would choose matrix P that would satisfy this equation, then any transposed state vector times this result times the state vector will be always a negative scalar. Now, what do we know about this equation? It is called Lyapunov equation. And the Lyapunov equation should be solved using a computer tool. One can solve it on an element-by-element basis. To do so, you have to define matrix AM and matrix Q. But it's much better to define matrix A and matrix Q and solve this equation using a computer tool. And I also want to tell you upfront, for matrix Q, I traditionally use unit matrix, just unit matrix. It works beautifully. We want the derivative of the Lyapunov function to be negative definite. So if matrix P is properly chosen according to the Lyapunov equation, the rest that we have to do is to make sure that two other terms in the equation, specifically this term and this term, are negative definite, are equal to zero. If this is negative definite, this is zero, and this is zero, the entire derivative will be a negative definite function. How to make them equal to zero? Well, we have to satisfy this equation and satisfy this equation. And if we will do so, the adaptation mechanism for the matrix A of the adjustable system, actually this is derivative of the matrix A, will be defined by this expression. And derivative of matrix B of the adjustable system will be defined by this expression. If this is done, and this is done, then we can define matrix A of the closed loop system as initial conditions plus the integral of this derivative, and matrix B will be defined as some initial conditions plus integral of this matrix B derivative. And now, look, this is the result that we can easily accept and use, and then we shouldn't have to worry about the complexity of the Lyapunov function and the derivative of the Lyapunov function. The next, we have to keep in mind that FA and FB are positive definite matrices, and as such, they could be also chosen to be quite simple. Look at this. The next, what we do, this is matrix A of the adjustable system as a function of error and time, and of course it's equal to matrix A of the controlled plant minus matrix B of the controlled plant times matrix F of the controller. And I can rewrite it again once more. It is matrix A of the controlled plant, matrix B of the controlled plant times the initial condition for time-dependent matrix F. And this is matrix B multiplied by the time-dependent increment of matrix F. Now, these two terms we can assemble together into a closed loop of zero initial conditions for matrix A. And this is the integral, this integral, that could be defined based on the matrix P solution of the Lyapunov equation, positive definite matrix FA, vector of errors in the system, and the transposed state vector of the controlled plant. Now, matrix A closed loop of zero is this, as I said, and B matrix time delta F matrix is equal to this. And from this condition, we should be able to define matrix delta F, the increment of the matrix F of the state variable controller as a function of error in time. With the matrix B, we go exactly through the same gymnastics. And guess what? We will end up having matrix B of the closed loop system that has time dependent increment of the matrix W, the filter in the reference channel. And it's equal to this integral. And from this equation, we should be able to establish the increment of the matrix W. So we will end up with the following system block diagram. This is the reference model that represents the desired closed loop system dynamics. This is the controlled plant. For the controlled plant, we have state variable controller. But the matrix F of the state variable controller consists of initial conditions for this matrix F plus time-dependent increment. And this is the filter in the reference channel. And you can see that it depends on the initial conditions for this filter and the increment that depends on time. And the adaptation mechanism is the computational procedure that defines increment delta F and the increment delta W. It is done on the basis of error. But according to this equation, it will also require the reference and the state vector of the controlled plant. So if I would be more careful, I should show reference coming is applied to this box, and the state vector of the plant also should be applied to the adaptation mechanism. The best what I can do at this point is to show you a numerical example. We will start from the controlled plant defined by a best guess definition. State variable equation for the controlled plant. Y is the state vector for the controlled plant. AP and BP are matrix A and matrix B of the controlled plant. And I also put a output equation for the controlled plant. And this is particular definition of matrix AP and particular definition of matrix BP. And this is the matrix C. And it looks like the system output is equal to the first state variable of the plant. If you will take a look at the eigenvalues of the fundamental matrix of the best guess plant, it has two right-hand side eigenvalues, which means that the plant is unstable and it has to be stabilized by using a state variable controller. If you would get a transfer function for this control plant, you will also see that there is right-hand side zero in the transfer function. So this control plant is not a simple thing to handle. The desired closed-loop system dynamics is defined by this state equation, and I also added the output equation. Now, I chose the fundamental matrix and matrix B such that we would have perfect response in this system, required settling time and required overshoot and required steady state value. So look, with this matrix AM, with this matrix B and this matrix C, we have this almost perfect. Well, actually, it is a perfect response of the reference model to a unit step reference. The eigenvalues are minus 1, which is dominant, minus 4, and minus 6, non-dominant. So everything is perfect. In order to design the state variable controller, we have to proceed with the design of the with the design procedure. And our design procedure requires us to take the state variable description of the controlled plant and convert it into the canonical controllable form. How we do it? Following the procedure presented to my students in 462 class. And this is the matrix M, the filter that we use to perform the conversion. These are equations for the conversion. This is matrix A of the CCF for the plant, far from being perfect. This is matrix B for the canonical controllable form of the plant. It must have this structure. And this is matrix C for the canonical controllable form of the plant. And you could figure out easily by looking at these numbers that the transfer function of the control plant has one right-hand side zero. And the impact of this is that we will not be able to insert a filter in the reference channel to cancel zeros. Now we have to proceed with the definition of the controller. And this is done according to what you know in 462 class. And this is the controller. But if you still remember from the 462 class, this controller is expecting the state vector of the canonical controllable form that is effectively a mathematical fiction. So we have to replace this controller by this controller by post multiplying by matrix M. And this is the controller prepared to work with the actual state variables of the control plane. I run this expression to define steady state values for state variables of the control plant for the closed loop system, okay? This is for the closed loop system fundamental matrix. I have these values. And then I obtained the closed loop fundamental matrix for the design system. These are the values for the closed loop fundamental matrix of the closed loop system. And just to check if our design is correct, I took eigenvalues of this matrix, and they are equal exactly to minus 1, minus 4, and minus 6, which means that our design was successful. We obtained a system, closed-loop system, with the fundamental matrix equal to the, the eigenvalues of the fundamental matrix equal to the eigenvalues of the reference model. You know, fundamental matrices are different, but their eigenvalues are the same for the closed-loop system and for the reference model. And then I applied unit step to the closed-loop system, and I applied the final value theorem to take a look at the steady-state values of the variables, state variables. And these are the steady state values for the state variables. Why do we need something like this? I guess in order to design the matrix W in the reference channel, if necessary. Now I can tell you a little bit more about the control system design. The control plane has right-hand side zeros. We will not attempt to cancel zeros of the plane. They could not be canceled. However, let's take a look at the step response of the system. The step response of our closed-loop system with the appropriately chosen matrix W in the reference channel, it is just a constant matrix. It's not a dynamic filter, just a constant matrix. You see, it's basically a very good response. However, it shows some very small undershoot, and the reason for this undershoot is having one right-hand side zero of the control plant that we could not eliminate. The next, we solve the Lyapunov equation. This is matrix AM of the reference model, transposed. We chose unity for matrix Q. And we found matrix P by using the tool. This is matrix AM, this is matrix Q, this is matrix P, generated by the software tool. Now we have matrix P defined. The next that we have to do, we have to go back to the equation that defines BP, matrix B of the control plane, times matrix delta F, the increment of the matrix F. It's defined by this integral. How to handle this BP part? And how to handle the FA matrix? For FA matrix, we can use just unit matrix to keep things simple. All right? And we can consider unity matrix times some positive constant. This positive constant could be equal to basically any number you want it to be equal, a reasonable number. All right? Now, I want you to recall that matrix BP is this matrix. What will happen if I will multiply matrix BP, this expression by BP transposed, and this expression by BP transposed. What will happen is this. This is BP transposed times matrix BP times delta F. It's equal to matrix BP transposed times P times K times this integral. You know, this product is a scalar equal to 38. And I can always move this 38 in the right-hand side of this expression. And this 38 number, or 1 over 38, will be absorbed by this positive constant K1. This is easy to do. And then I will have a very user-friendly expression for the increment of matrix F. It's in front of you. I moved all constants to the left, of the in this expression. I pulled it out from the integral. Now, want to remind you that this ER components of the vector error vector. State variable 1 of the reference model minus state variable 1 of the control plant, and so on. All right. Now, how about this product? I got this product. Matrix. BP transposed times matrix P. It is right here, written in front of you. Yeah, it's 1 by 3. This is 3 by 3. So result is 1 by 3. And I have this vector calculated, or this matrix calculated. I can move it under the integral sign now. Look what I have now. Delta F is equal to constant K1 stays in front of this integral. Under the integral, I have this matrix times the vector of errors. You know, this part. I decided it's a scalar. 1 by 3 times 3 by 1, it's a scalar. The scalar depends on error 1, error 2, and error 3, but it's still a scalar. I call it Q. Oh, excuse me, this is omega. I call it omega. I could call it any name I want. I called it omega. What will happen now? I have delta F defined on the element by element basis. Delta F1 is constant times integral of Q times Y1 dt. Delta F2 is a constant times integral. Under the integral, I have the same omega. It's not Q, it's omega, times Y2. And delta F3 is equal to the constant times integral. And under the integral sign, I have this omega, times state variable Y3, not Z, people. Can you please fix it? It's not Z, this is Y3. Y3, this is a typo. All right. Now, the same trick I can perform with respect to increment delta W as error in time, multiplying left-hand side and right-hand side by BP transposed. In the left-hand side, I will get 38 again. In the right-hand side, I will have BP transposed times this integral. For FB, I will use K2 times unity. So it's very easy to figure out what happens. Reference is a scalar. So the omega expression is still this omega expression, okay? I'm getting the delta omega as a function of time, the adaptation mechanism. And the next that we have to do is to implement our results in the simulation environment. First of all, I define the reference model. It is fully consistent with the reference model definition. But I want to tell you, I defined it on an element-by-element basis so that I would have access to every individual state variable. You know, technically I could use matrix definitions to get the same result. This is better because this gives you kind of very intimate access to the simulation that you perform and to model reference problem. You know, this is the best guess control plant. You know what this is? This is a true control plant. You know, if I would just design my system and implement the adaptation mechanism and apply it to the best guess controlled plant, we don't need adaptation. And our adaptation mechanism will show absolutely nothing to us. The catch is to apply this not to the best guess controlled plant, but to a so-called true controlled plant. So I took the best guess control plan definition, slightly modified it, and not that slightly, modified it. And then the use of the model reference approach makes sense. Here you can see the adaptation procedure. Following everything what I said earlier, I compute omega. Don't forget that omega is equal to matrix BP transposed times matrix P, which is the solution of the Lyapunov equation, times the vector of errors. The result is a scalar, it's omega. And now I use omega to compute increment of the first element of matrix F1, increment of the second element of matrix F, and increment of the third element of matrix F of the state variable controller. Okay? And this is the increment of the scalar W, because matrix W in the reference channel, it's a scalar. And now you can see the adaptive controller. I have initial condition for matrix W. It came out of our system design. I am adding the increment time dependent. They are added. This gives me the filter in the reference channel. And here comes the reference. The reference is multiplied by this result. Then I have initial condition for element F1, increment for element F1 earlier calculated. It is multiplied by Y1, first state variable of the control plant, and it goes to the summation. Similarly, I'm getting the product of the second state variable by the matrix F with time-dependent increment and result of multiplication of the third component of the state vector times matrix F with these initial conditions. This is all added together. The sign is changed because it's supposed to be negative feedback. And this is the control effort applied to the control plan. And this is the system. I'm using a sinusoidal signal. This is the reference. Okay. Each of these blocks is shown separately earlier. This control plant is not the best guess plant. This is the true plant. The adaptation mechanism is here, adaptive controller is here, reference model is here. And you can see clearly that before I said something, this run is in the situation for the situation when the adaptation mechanism is disabled. How to disable adaptation mechanism? There are constants, K1 and K2 in the adaptation mechanism. I can make them zeros. So what you can see, there is a sustained difference in behavior between the red reference model and the blue, the adjustable system. And now you can see the another run, but this time the adaptation mechanism is enabled, and you can see what's supposed to happen. And now the discrepancy between reference model and adjustable system decreases. And if I would run it for a very long time, it will become equal to zero. Don't forget about global asymptotic stability or perfect asymptotic adaptation. But then you have to be realistic. When you run a simulator, the longer you run the simulator, the more error accumulation process plays its dirty role. And if I would keep running this for longer time, the system will get unstable. But it's not the model reference system unstable. It will be the instability of my simulation software. This is what will happen. And now we completed a sizable part of our material, and I'm considering giving you a test number one. And this test number one will be offered you in class. The purpose of this test is make sure that I can have information for objective assessment of your academic performance, of your achievements. At the same time, I want you to get the idea of what kind of problems you may face during the test number one. I'm not going to give you exactly the same problems because it would be just insulting your intelligence. Problems will be different, but these are the types of the problems that you should be able to solve. First of all, I will come up with problems that would enable you to differentiate, to recognize various types of model reference systems. For example, this is the identifier. The model, a reference model here is the real physical plant. And the adjustable system is a simulator with adjustable parameters. You find the discrepancy between two responses and use it in the adaptation mechanism. And the adaptation mechanism is supposed to provide you with values of adjustable parameters. So you may also agree with me that this is a system with parametric adaptation. You may also agree with me that this is a parallel configuration of the system. This is a state observer. State observer works a little bit differently. In the state observer, the most important is to provide exactly the same system response as the response of the reference model. So reference model here is a real physical system. Adjustable system is a simulator with fixed parameters. We extract the difference between the responses. We use adaptation mechanism. And this adaptation mechanism is supposed to push the simulator to follow the reference model to make sure that the error is very close to zero. It's also a parallel configuration. This is a control system with parametric adaptation. You're supposed to see here a reference model. Here is a simulator. And the simulator has fixed parameters. You understand that this reference model represents the design specs. This is a real physical system. It's a controlled plant with adjustable control circuitry. You extract the discrepancy between two responses. Your adaptation mechanism generates values of adjustable parameters of the controller. I guess it is nothing but the system with parametric adaptation, and it's also a parallel configuration. Model reference control system with signal adaptation. Very similar situation, except for the adjustable system, you have a real physical process with fixed parameters of control circuitry. The adaptation mechanism injects in the system additional control effort, additional input signal that forces the system to follow the reference model. Well, look, I always like to tell my students that the reference model is simulation software, okay? A simulation software is inside of a flight control computer. The real physical process could be subjected to various types of external effects, vibration, earthquake, overheating, and things of this nature. As a result, you will see this error. It's a negative feedback arrangement. You will see this error. The adaptation mechanism is the mechanism that will be able to eliminate this error. So it will be pushing the adjustable system, the physical plant and its controller, to follow the reference model in spite of earthquake, rain, cold, overheating, and so on. Now I want to consider with you, and I want you to have a very... And now I want to discuss with you model reference system with parallel configuration, because I want you to be able to recognize such a system. First of all, you have the description of the reference model. You have the description of the adjustable system. And I want you to realize that the same input is applied at the reference model and the adjustable system. The rest is extraction of the error and the adaptation mechanism. However, this is applicable to state variable definition of the model reference system. What if we have a transfer function definition? This is the transfer function block with fixed parameters representing the reference model. The input is U of S. The output is Y model. This is the transfer function block representing the adjustable system. The input is the same input U of S. The error is found as the difference between output of the model and output of the system. However, in the numerator of the adjustable system, you can see that the Laplace variable you do see, but you also should realize that parameters of the numerator are dependent on error and time. In the denominator, it's also a polynomial denominator is assumed, S is the Laplace variable, but parameters are functions of error and time. The series parallel configuration in state variable definition has this description. The description shows the reference model with the state vector xm fundamental matrix AM, state vector XM, matrix BM, and U, the input signal. For the system with adjustable parameters, you can see state vector X of the system, which is different from XM. But take a look. This is the fundamental matrix. It's multiplied by the state vector of the model. It's quite different. And then you have plus matrix B of the adjustable system times the input U. Error is defined as XM minus X system. But if you're looking into the state variable, not state variable, but the transfer function definition, the model is defined by a transfer function block. The input is U, the output is YM. But the adjustable system has clearly two parts. This is the serious part of the system, In the serious part of the system, in the numerator of the transfer function is one, denominator is polynomial N system that depends on the adjustable parameters beta. And the input is the output of the reference model. In the parallel adjustable system, this is the transfer function block. In the transfer function block, you will see the denominator. And denominator is a polynomial with adjustable parameters alpha. The input is the input of the reference model. And the output is output of the parallel adjustable system. And the error is defined as output of the serious system minus output of the parallel system. If you will take a look at this mathematical definition, you should realize that if parameters beta are properly defined, and if parameters alpha are properly defined, what happens? This denominator would cancel the numerator of the reference model. And what is left will be very close to this transfer function block. This is a model reference system with a purely serious configuration. There is no equivalent in transfer function definition. In the state variable definition, but the transfer function definition shows very clearly that we cancel completely dynamics of the reference model by the dynamics of the serious adjustable system. If dynamics is canceled, the overall transfer function is one, and therefore error is calculated as the original input minus the output of the series system. I want you to realize that various configurations of this type have various advantages one over another one in terms of noise effects, in terms of computational difficulties, and so on. I also want you to come to the test and be able to read through schematics of composite model reference systems. What you can see here is a model reference control system. It has model reference series parallel state observer and model reference state variable controller and with parametric adaptation. How to look at such a system? First of all, I would suggest to see the controlled plant. It is right here. You see the controlled plant. Right here you can see the controlled plant. Matrix B of the plant, matrix A of the plant, state vector Y, and matrix C of the plant. The controlled plant works as a reference model for the state observer. Look what happens. This is the state observer. It has matrix B of the observer, or of the adjustable system, because observer is adjustable system. It has matrix A of the observer. It is our adjustable system here. And you have matrix C. Z is the state vector of the observer. Look what happens. It's a serious parallel configuration, because in the equation for the state observer, look at this, derivative of state vector Z is equal to matrix A of the state observer times the state vector of the controlled plant, not Z, but Y, plus matrix B of the state observer times the control effort of the control plant. But then you have this addition. This is the adaptation signal, and the purpose of this adaptation signal is to make sure that the output of the state observer is very close to the output of the control plant, and hopefully the state vector of the state observer gives appropriate, accurate representation of the state vector of the control plant. You may ask me, why do we need state observer here? We need state observer because the state vector of the control plant may not be sampled with the necessary frequency. But then you have to take a look at the model reference controller. This is the reference model that represents the desired system dynamics. The input is the reference, the same reference that is applied to the control system. The state of the reference model is compared against the state of the controlled plant. Probably the sampling frequency is sufficient for the adaptation mechanism. And you have this error. So there are two errors. One error represents how close the state observer is to controlled plant. And the second error shows the discrepancy between the reference model and the control system. Two adaptation mechanisms. Adaptation mechanism number two is in charge of adjusting parameters of the control circuitry. And the adaptation mechanism number one is in charge of generating a signal that is injected to the input of the state observer to achieve high accuracy of state observation. The next, I want to talk to you a little bit more about simulation techniques, because I know from some emails that I am receiving, some students are not very strong with the simulation. Well, let me show you. This is a state variable equation, state equation of some dynamic system, and this is the same equation represented in the simulator. Look, B, 5 and minus 3 are these two elements. They participate in the first state equation. Minus 2 and 1 are these two state variables. They participate in the second state equation. There are two state variables. Now, 9 and minus 4 are elements of the matrix B. They are right here. So look what happens. If I would add together x1 times 5 and x2 times minus 3 and the input signal times 9, I'm getting the x1 dot. I integrate it. I'm getting x1, and x1 I use in my simulation system. Similarly, you can discuss what happens with the state variable x2. Now you can see that because of this wiring or connection lines, our system is unnecessarily complex, and I should use this word hairy. To eliminate this problem, we use in simulation variable identifiers. So having variable identifier x1 at this location is and having it at this location means that x1 is defined here and applied at this location. So go through the state variable identifier and learn how to understand what exactly system does, even if you do not have this complex wiring in the system. The next that you have to keep in mind is that our simulation allows us to define systems with time-dependent parameters. Look what happens here. The state variable z1 is obtained by integration of z1 dot. But to get z1 dot, take a look at this equation. I need z1 multiplied by time-dependent a11 plus z2 multiplied by time-dependent a12 plus variable u multiplied by time-dependent variable b1. So look, for variable a11, for variable a12, for variable b1, I use identifiers. They're not constants like they could be, but instead they are variables. They are variables. And of course, these variables could be defined somewhere in the simulation schematics. For example, a11 is defined as some initial conditions 4.3 plus the time-dependent increment that is equal to 9 times integral, and under the integral sign I have some kind of variable x2 and some kind of variable e. So you should be able to read the simulation diagrams without any problems. The next what I want to talk to you about the local parametric optimization. I am providing you an example, and something of this nature you may see during the test number one. Take a look at the reference model. It is represented by a transfer function. Take a look at the adjustable system. It's a same or similar second order transfer function, but its parameters are time dependent. I want you to look at this. This always could be done in a transfer function. The zero order term I made equal to 1, and you know how to do it. You may be required to define the adaptation mechanism, which is parameter a2 as a function of time, parameter a1 as a function of time, b1 as a function of time, and b0 as a function of time. First, we compute the error. Look, here error is fully spelled out. This is the reference model times the input minus adjustable system times the input. This is the criterion that has to be minimized because local parametric optimization does not call for any stability conditions, but it implies that we will introduce some criterion and then minimize it. How we minimize it? By gradient. This is my definition of the criterion. This 1 over 2 is built in to avoid some unnecessary writing that would have to take place when you take derivative of this criterion. Okay? So this criterion is spelled out here. This is expression for the error. And you also have to look at this expression and realize that the criterion is a function of this time-dependent parameters b1, b2, a2, and a1. The next is gradient minimization of a function of four parameters, quadratic function of four parameters. This is the gradient. The gradient is a vector, and this vector consists of partial derivatives of the criterion with respect to parameters A2, A1, B1, and B0. Now, if you want to minimize the criterion, parameters A2, A1, B1, and B0 should be incremented. And this is how these increments could be defined. It's always minus because we're supposed to move not in the direction of gradient, but in the opposite direction. K is a constant, and here are partial derivatives. As I mentioned in class, the gradient is nothing but a navigational instrument. Then we can take time derivatives of these increments, and we will get the rate of change for each of these parameters. And as you take these derivatives, look, this is a time derivative of delta A. It has minus k time derivative of, this is the criterion, derivative of the criterion. Okay? The order of differentiation could be always changed, and therefore what we have is minus k. K is a positive constant, and then partial derivative of the time derivative of the criterion. Exactly the same thing. Rate of change of this parameter is equal to minus k. K is a positive constant, and then I have partial derivative of this time derivative of the criterion Q. Again, I will repeat it once more. Constant with minus, this is the partial derivative of the derivative of the criterion, time derivative of the criterion, and so on. Now let's carefully go through the further transformation of these expressions. Look, rate of change of parameter A2 is minus constant k. This is the partial derivative with respect to A2 of the time derivative of q. But you remember how time derivative of q looks like. It's in a d over dt of the 1 over 2 integral of e squared. So the time differentiation and the time integration eliminate each other, and we have, and at the same time, we need, when we take derivative of the error squared, we have 2 times error. Error is defined as ym minus ys. Ym is independent of parameter A2, but ys is dependent of parameter A2. So if you go through all the stuff, you will end up having constant gain with plus now times error times partial derivative of y of s output of the adjustable system. Can you take this partial derivative of y of s with respect to A2? This definition of the transfer function helps because if you would go through this algebra, you will understand that y of s is equal to this expression. And you know how to take derivative of this expression with respect to A2. Actually, you know how to take derivative of this expression with respect to A1 and so on. And then you're getting a whole bunch of equations for the rate of change. But they depend now on the time derivatives of the output, time derivative of the output, time derivative of the control effort, time derivative of the control effort. Just make sure that you maintain correct signs, and what you can see is the adaptation mechanism. And the approach is known as the MIT rule. And finally, I want to talk to you about the use of Lapunov stability conditions for model reference design. Problem like this may show up in your exam number one. First of all, we have a model reference system. It is described by the state variables, and in combinations, the state variables create the state vector of the system. The state variables include output variable of the reference model, output variable of the adjustable system, the input variable of the reference model, error, control effort, or adaptation signal. I guess this is the adaptation signal, because it is defined as a function of error and time. And you have two more parameters defined as a function of error and time. The three of them constitute the adaptation mechanism in the system. Now, what I am not going to assign you to do is the definition of the Lapunov function. I suggested the definition of the Lapunov function. But the most important to me is not the Lapunov function per se, but the derivative of the Lapunov function. So I guess the function is something, and its derivative has this expression. You understand that by the choice of the adaptation mechanism, you have to make sure that this derivative is negative definite. I want you to take a look at the particular components of this derivative. Take a look at this derivative. Take a look at this component. This is a vector multiplied by the vector. Vector transposed multiplied by the vector. You understand that this result is a quadratic function. It's equal to r squared plus e squared plus u squared. And also notice that there is minus in front of this expression. So this part defines a negative constant. Negative constant. And I guess this negative constant in the origin, when each of these variables are zeros, will be equal to zero. I also want you to take a look at this expression. Again, it is a transposed vector times vector. It's a quadratic expression. It's equal to x squared plus y squared plus w squared. All right? Now, there is minus in front of it. So I guess this expression is always negative. However, if x, y, and w are zeros, this expression is zero. And I also want you to realize that you have this expression, simple expression. It is minus 123 times h squared. It is a negative expression. If h is zero, then this expression is zero. So what you have here is something that I can write together three components of the derivative. I can put them together. I will call them phi of x, and I can swear that phi of x is a negative definite function. If somehow I will make sure that this derivative is equal to phi of x, everything will be perfect. The derivative of the Lapunov function will be negative definite function. How can I make this expression to be equal to phi of x? If these three terms will be equal to zero, and from these three terms, I am getting the whatever I need for the adaptation mechanism. I'm getting these results that lead me to this adaptation mechanism.